This video will show you how to perform measurements of the function of the middle ear using the Mako TouchTemp line. Set up the device with a power cord and connect the probe to the TouchTemp. Briefly press the front key on the front of the TouchTemp to turn on the device. The display will show the Mako splash screen. Before performing any measurements, take care of a quiet environment. Make sure that the patient is comfortably on a chair or on an examination table if necessary. Small children may feel more comfortable sitting on a parent's lap. A test frequency of 226 Hz is always pre-selected as default to quickly start a test. 226 Hz testing is recommended for adults and children older than half a year. Depending on your device configuration and per test license, you can choose a frequency of 1000 Hz, 678 Hz or 800 Hz. Choose the ear by pressing on the corresponding tympanogram, the ear buttons or the probe button. By default, the measurement will be started as soon as the probe is properly placed in the ear. The measured curve will be displayed simultaneously to the ongoing test. Additionally, the test status will be displayed on the LEDs of the probe. To evaluate the result of your measurement, normative data from acknowledged standards is used. A result is considered a pass if the maximum compliance is in the normative range. A result is considered a no response when the maximum compliance is outside of this normative box. Depending on measured frequency and settings, normative boxes are displayed. Depending on your device configuration, you can print the result. If you have a PC connected to your TouchTemp, you may transfer the measurement results to the PC and the Mako session software. Before performing measurements of the acoustic reflex, a tympanometry is performed to find the maximum compliance pressure for better performance. Depending on your device configuration, you can measure ipsi and or contralateral reflexes with various pure tone or noise stimuli. Before measuring, select or deselect your preferred stimuli or fine-tune your default selections within the settings. The measurement starts automatically once the probe is properly placed in the ear. Otherwise, please press the play button for manual operation. At the conclusion of the test, the result symbol appears at the top right corner of the box. A green check mark indicates a present reflex. A red cross indicates no response. To be considered as a pass, the maximum amplitude of the reflex shape must reach a pass criterion within a defined time range. Otherwise, it is considered as no response. The test results can be reviewed and edited individually in the edit mode. To clean the probe, remove the single-use ear tip and dispose it. Wipe all probe parts with disinfectant wipes. inspect the probe tip for debris. To clean, unscrew the upper part of the black probe housing so the probe tube can be removed. Use floss to go through the canals of the probe tube and remove residual wax. Place the probe tube on the base of the probe, put the upper part of the probe on top and assemble it back together. Disinfect the housing of the touch tube and its accessories by wiping the surfaces with a disinfectant wipe. Thank you for watching this video and stay tuned.